It's me.
I'm Steve.
And Steve has a sore neck. So he's turning his head funny and I'm making fun of him. Today we are at the
Museum of Flight.
Museum of Flight. He's right. In Seattle. And it is the largest private, did I read that? Largest private Museum of Flight in the U.S.? In the world.
In the world.
In the world. So we'll see what they have. We've been to quite a few flight museums and we've seen some amazing stuff. So I look forward to this one, see what they have. Come along. Cutest ornaments ever. Dogs in space. Oh, they also have monkeys. Oh my gosh, that's cute. And tortoises. And more tortoises, I think. So this one's obviously Wright Brothers. They have older ones.
Are you on there?
So this is a reproduction of the world's first powered airplane. Very cool looking. This is from the early days of airmail. This area is the Great Gallery. Trying to get some of the smaller planes back there, and then we'll see if we can get closer. McAllister Yakima Clipper, designed and built by Washington State native Charles McAllister. And I'll show you the actual plane in a moment. That one. Boeing model 80A1.
Got some coats there.
It is right here, those big old wheels. Good grief, that's a big plane. Oh, wow. Wow.
Coming.
Okay, now this one's a bit bizarre. A flying automobile. So it's a car, plane. It's totally bizarre. Lear Fan 2100 corporate prop jet is up there. Seems awfully small for a corporate jet. Trying to fit into a cockpit.
Actually,
wait, roomy. Is it roomy?
Yeah. Wait, what, isn't it? Yeah.
I'm not gonna say anything about. What is that?
Blackbird cockpit.
Blackbird.
Well, front half of a Blackbird cockpit.
Oh yeah, it's just the cockpit part.
Yeah,
but...
yeah. Basically, front half of that. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Douglas DC-3 is an Alaskan Airlines, or American Airlines. Well, it says Alaska Airlines. It's that one there. Apologies if I get any of these wrong. I don't know my planes. And even with pictures, I'm not so certain. Aeronca? I don't know how to say that word. C-2. The flying bathtub. Wow. And this one's obvious because it's orange. Let's see if I can step back and get. There we go. The flying bathtub. Wooden propeller. There we go, that's the whole plane. Lockheed Model 10E Electra 1935. That's a big plane. Okay, this fascinates me. This is part of Amelia Earhart's crashed plane, not the one they've never found, but the one before it. Plane was repaired and a month later is when she disappeared.
The computerized tool then predicts the arrival time to the airport for each incoming aircraft, using other important information like aircraft size.
So this is what US Air 737 Airline Theater. Nice big seats. This is a trainer for the space shuttle. This is the buggy. How cool is that? The Red Barn, the original Boeing Airplane Factory. A wee longer. And there's Steve getting ready to walk around. first airplane. A lot of wood. I don't know if I would trust it. Obviously it worked. Boeing model 40B fuselage reproduction. I like, since they are obviously in Seattle in the Northwest, they have a focus on Northwest aviation. I quite like that. Well, there's Charlie McAllister again. I like they're also including women's flight history, among the few women students in the 1920s. Not on you, you won't do this. Instrument and radio trainer, the blue box. It's tiny. It's a wee blue box. Shaped like a paper plane. love how the exhibits have planes and big pieces, but small pieces and individual pieces and information on individuals. So it kind of gives you a fuller picture than just the airplanes. Fascinating. Downstairs was World War II. This is World War I. And there's Steve's head.
So this picture, and Morocco.
How the map has changed. This whole thing was Austria.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
There's all kinds of, there's all kinds of countries.
Look at the seat.
Yeah.
That's the seat for this plane. How crazy. I don't see any seatbelts.
Seem to spring up in one great roar and flame.
I hope this puts your mind at ease. We should be moving along. Yeah. Any other questions?
No. Well, yes. Just one more.
Go ahead.
What are my chances of leaving? My chances of leaving this world.
You wouldn't know. You have to remember, it's a different war when fought in the skies than the one on the ground.
Oh, Love the purple. And they have a Concorde. We were just on the Concorde in Scotland, so it's funny. Side. Then if you kept going, your seats. And then out of the wee door, duck so you don't hit your head. Unmistakable shape of that wing. You tell it's a Concorde. our day at the Museum of Flight. What do you think?
Good. Yeah. Really good.
It was interesting to see a Concorde when we just saw the Concorde in Scotland. And we've been on Air Force One before. One of them.
Yeah.
Somewhere. Dayton. Yeah. So it was quite interesting. Good way to spend the day.
Yeah, I recommend it.
Yeah. It was really good. Thank you all for coming along. Thank you all so much.
Bye.